We have very real, very frightening things happening around us right now. The weather is showing its terrifying power. Wildfires are raging across vast portions of this country. Floods are wiping out communities. Hurricanes have decimated entire island countries and shut down major portions of our country. Earthquakes are occurring. Tornadoes, hail, storms, lightning, winds. Our political divides are so deep that many are wondering if we are on the verge of a second civil war. Whites are slowly awakening to the disparate actions of police and courts when it comes to people of color. Heterosexual cisgender people are starting to see the prejudice toward gender and sexuality minorities. People are angry, and their anger is growing. But in the midst of all the uncertainty and fear, the sun rises each morning. Birds still sing, flowers still bloom, babies are still being born, teens dream of their futures, lovers marry, and people still make plans for tomorrow, next week, next month, and even years from now. We can focus on the lions and tigers and bears until we no longer have any life at all, just fear. Or we can act a little brave, remind ourselves that we walk with God, take a few breaths, and change the mantra from recurrent phrases of fear to a continuous loop of comfort and hope. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? I believe that I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult. Be still and know that I am God. We are reminded throughout life that we need to be prepared. We need to know that we should always have some non-perishable foods on hand. Never, ever, ever run out of toilet paper. When a storm is predicted, make sure you have water available. Keep extra batteries on hand. Preparing our hearts, minds, and souls is also important. Scary times come. Frightening things do happen. People get very, very sick, and we become afraid we might lose them. People get hurt. Wars happen. Car accidents happen. Cancer happens. Natural disasters happen. Waiting for news is a long, lonely time of worry, fear, and dread. But when we're prepared with comforting words and reassurance, we can remind ourselves that God is with us. We can reach for those words just like we reached for our mom's or our dad's hand when we were little and facing a potential danger. We held their hand when we crossed the road, and with our hands securely in theirs, we got safely to the other side. We can hold God's promises when we're crossing the great divide between what we know and the unknown future. We can find comfort and knowing that peace is available to us all the time, even in the most dangerous circumstances, because our peace is internal and not dependent on our circumstances. We can be still and know that God is God no matter the storm. The things happening around us right now have many people thinking the end times are near. Climate experts are telling us we're beginning a countdown to a point of no return for this planet. There are wars and rumors of wars. The sky turned dark. Was the eclipse a spectacular natural phenomenon or an omen of ominous times ahead? Even in things as out of our control as the weather and international affairs, even then, we do have control over our own responses. We can get caught up in the whirlwind of fear and despair, or we can ask ourselves, if God is my stronghold, who or what should I fear? We can listen for God's still speaking voice, reminding us to be at peace, telling us, be still and know that I am God. We can sense the whisper to our hearts, the words that calm the storms in our minds, peace, be still. And secure in knowing we aren't supposed to be the ones in control, we can take another deep breath, calm our breathing, relax our tense shoulders, and pretend we're brave, just brave enough to get through the next moments of uncertainty. Then when we've accomplished that great feat, we can do it again and get through the next moment and the next until living with courage and hope becomes our natural state. Always, always, we can remind ourselves to listen for our message. Be still and know that I am God. Let us live in peace, loving God, loving ourselves, loving each other. Let us persist, securely holding on to God's hand as we continue walking our life's journey, whether in sunshine or in storms. Amen. We respond to God by sharing our offering. Thank you.